don't like interrupting this lovely piece of music. Pianist is Stuart Jones from the album Eternal Dream. And this lovely number is called Timeless Nature. And on cue, the birds outside have started. I have my door wide open here. It's very quiet just now, and now they're chirping away, which is really lovely. Thank you for your messages. I have been reading them, didn't like to interrupt the music, and I will be sending out healing, obviously, to you all during this session. So just sit back now and relax. I'll leave the music playing quietly in the background whilst we get started. And you're quite correct, I'm not Tara today. She's having a well-earned rest this morning, and we'll be back with you hopefully next Sunday. So good morning everyone, and thank you for joining with the rest of us today for the Healing Minute. And we're very grateful to you all, this community of ours, like-minded people sending out healing to each other and to the world. And an extra big welcome to any newbies today. Every week we seem to have one or two new people joining us, even though we've been doing this now for very nearly 4 years. It's quite remarkable. We started this on the 31st of March during lockdown in 2020. So almost our 4 year anniversary coming up. So just sit back, as I say, if it's safe to do so, close your eyes and just be still. Imagine a column of pure white light entering your entire being and be in the presence of this love and this light. Sit and rest for a moment and begin to sense the earth energy, the healing energy from the divinity. You are each a conduit for both energies. Allow them to flow through you. And you can fill your entire being with these energies by just being. Now picture yourself in a beautiful log cabin high up in the mountains. It is the middle of the winter, and you can hear the soft sound of the wind outside. You're sitting comfortably in front of a lovely log fire, feeling the warmth and watching the flames. And smell the smoke from the wood that is burning there in the hearth. Hear the crackling and hissing as the sap falls and hits the flames. See the shadows flickering on the walls around you. The only light is coming from the glow of the fire. The rest of the cabin is in deep purple darkness. Now look out of the window. It is covered with a lacy pattern of frost. And as you put your warm fingertips on the hard, cold glass, feel their warmth melt some of the ice. And looking out of that window, stars fill the sky. Tall evergreen trees cast bluish shadows against the white snow. So open the window for a moment and take in a big, deep breath. Crisp, pure, cool and clean, fresh mountain air. It feels so good to breathe. Your entire chest collapses in deep relaxation. Now close the window and walk over to the door. Put on your coat, the
your gloves, your boots and your scarf. Make sure you have a nice comfy hat on your head and open the door. And take in another deep breath of fresh mountain air. It feels so good. The moon is silver and full overhead, throwing bluish shadows everywhere. And go down the steps of the cabin and begin walking along a path. Tall trees on either side, loaded with snow. And take off one of your gloves and push your hand into a snowbank, grabbing some snow in your fist, compressing it into a ball of ice in the palm of your hand, and toss it through the air, seeing it explode against the trunk of a tree. And toss another and another high into the sky, and stand and admire the beautiful scene around you. Trees covered in snow, the sky full of stars, the wind blowing cold and gentle, and the moon casting those lovely shadows all around you. Give one of those trees a lovely big hug. Feel the energy from the tree, from Mother Nature, enveloping your whole body. Your hand might be feeling a little bit numb now, and your toes beginning to tingle. So put the glove back on your hand and start heading back to the cabin, retracing your footsteps in the snow. And the minutes pass until you reach the cabin once again. Now you notice the snowman, that beautiful snowman standing to the side of the cabin door. He's smiling straight at you, sending out his love to you. And you see the flicker of light from the glowing fire at the windows. So walk up the steps of the cabin, open the door and go back inside. It is warm and it is cozy. Take off your coat, your gloves, boots and scarf, so that all your outdoor clothing is cast aside as you walk over to the fireplace, holding out your hands towards the flames. Feeling the warmth slowly returning to your hands and to your toes. So make yourself comfortable in a lovely armchair or on the couch in front of the fire. And smell the smoke once again. Hear the crackling of the wood. And listen to the sound of the wind outside. Gradually let the sights, the sounds and the smells begin to drift away as we now prepare for the healing minute. From the point of light that I am, I let light stream forth from the mind of God. Earth radiates with light. From the point of love within the heart of God, I let love stream forth from my heart. I am a channel radiating energy on earth. From my centre, where the will of God is known, I let divine purpose guide me, the purpose which all masters know and serve. From the centre of the divine human race, let the plan of love and light work out. My love seals the door where evil dwells. I am the light and love and power, living God's plan on earth. So now, let all the people whose names we hold in the distant healing folder receive healing for their highest good. And we request healing for their family, their friends, their animals, and people for whom they have requested distant healing. And our healing thoughts go out to all of us and to the entire world. And in your intentions, let them all be placed in the healing light and receive that which they are allowed to receive for their highest good. So just for 1 minute, let us just be. Our thanks and our blessings for your help here today and all our wonderful friends in spirit. So thank you everybody, that was really lovely, lovely energy, thank you so much. So please remember, if you want healing or you just like a chat, we're here for you. Whether you come to the sanctuary for contact healing or you wish to have telephone or Zoom healings, just contact us in normal way to arrange an appointment. And the details are on our website and on our Facebook page. And just remember, we are transferring over to a new website. So bits might be on the old one and bits on the new one at the moment. Now, in less than an hour, at 11 o'clock this morning, Jean will be taking the Sunday service in the sanctuary. And our lovely friend Tony will bring you this service live on Facebook. So Tony should be coming up around 11ish. The service lasts for about 40 minutes. So do join for part of it, or all of it. Fingers crossed, technically, it'll all work okay. There'll be no hiccups. And if you're close enough to the sanctuary and you want to rush out now, please do so. Slip up to the sanctuary because Jean will be starting at 11 o'clock. Now tomorrow morning, Tracy will be here with the Healing Minute, as usual, 9:55. So do join her if you can. And next Thursday, the 29th, John will be bringing you his monthly meditation at 2 o'clock in the afternoon. And that will be on Zoom. And on Friday the 1st of March, Tara will be holding a gong bath in the sanctuary. 10:30 in the morning, Tara will be at the sanctuary. So do join her if you're in travel distance and you'd like to join in her gong bath. It is a wonderful session and I know that you'll enjoy it. And in the evening at 7:30, Teresa will be holding the Open Healing Circle on Zoom. Now this is on Zoom only, will not be on Facebook. So if you would like to join Teresa, just look out for the
for the Zoom link, which will be on the website and on Facebook. It is the normal Zoom link that we have been using for several years. So do join Teresa if you can, 7:30 on the 1st of March. Now, over the next few weeks, there will be some changes to the way in which we are advertising our events. Our new website is now online and it's being updated daily, ready for its official launch very soon. And you'll see some changes to our Facebook page as well. Now, please be gentle on us as the changes are made. We do have a few teething problems, and I'm sure we will have a few teething problems for a short while. So just bear with us whilst we get over that. Now, if there's anything you need to know, or you'd like to make any requests, please just contact the sanctuary in the usual way. Drop them a letter, an email, pick up the telephone. We are open 7 days a week, and between 10 in the morning and about 3 in the afternoon is the safest time to contact them, although we're open a little bit longer. Now, many of us will have had periods in our life when we have blamed ourselves for one thing or another, and we've blamed others for something that has occurred, and we have possibly found it hard to forgive them and to forgive ourselves. Now, my reading today was written by Rosemary Just and is all about taking responsibility, about acceptance and about forgiveness. It is called Forgiving Ourselves, written by Rosemary Just. We all mess up sometimes because we're all human. You may fail at some major life task, perhaps making your marriage work. Your actions may have hurt someone else. Maybe you've hurt yourself by drinking or doing something else that's self-destructive. Or maybe you didn't do something you thought you should, such as intervene in a family dispute or save money for your children's college fund. The list of potential human misdeeds is long. But our happiness depends on being able to reduce hurt and anger. Forgiveness is simple. It doesn't require an application for sainthood. If someone else did these things to us, we might learn to forgive them, or at least let go of the anger. So why is forgiving yourself so much harder than forgiving others? It's easier to forgive others because they don't live in your head, reading out the same old list of crimes over and over again. We seem to think we have to be perfect, yet people do things, intended or not, that hurt others. You may not intend to harm, but the other person is no less hurt. Most of us have a set of unconscious rules we have given ourselves about our own behaviour. Those rules, many of which were made up in childhood rather than actually thought about as an adult, and they're not always realistic. You may think forgiving yourself means that you let yourself get away with whatever it was you did. You may think your family and friends would never forgive you if they knew half of what you've done. The sheer awfulness of it crushes you with guilt and shame. How can you ever forgive yourself? Instead of taking responsibility for what was done, trying to repair the damage and making things right again, many of us simply decide to punish ourselves. We make ourselves feel miserable. The pain and anger we feel is supposed to be our punishment. No one can beat us up better than we can beat ourselves up. Unfortunately, this decision can have tragic consequences and are not always in obvious ways. If you keep beating yourself up, then anyone trying to love you is going to get beat up too. Someone wallowing in guilt is more likely to be withdrawn, more critical, and less open than they would otherwise be. So whoever's around is going to suffer right along with you. And the suffering doesn't stop with those around you. Mind affects body,
And those guilty feelings you're harbouring are generating destructive changes in your vital organs. Your heart rate increases, and there is a rise in your blood pressure. There may be disruption in your digestion. Your muscles tense, your blood cholesterol goes up, and your ability to think straight is reduced. And every time you remember what you did and wince, those bad feelings give you a fresh hit of all of this. It's no wonder that studies on forgiveness have led scientists to suspect that those who have difficulty forgiving are more likely to experience heart attacks, high blood pressure, depression, and other ills. Perhaps you don't necessarily want to reconcile with the person you hurt. You just want to get rid of the shame, release the blame, and feel calm and whole in yourself. When you can't forgive yourself because of something you've done to someone else, sometimes all it takes is a sincere apology to make things right. Or if the person you hurt is dead or otherwise absent, you can still make things right by providing a kindness to someone else. Feeling bad about things you've done in the past can create a pretty painful present. So while you're learning how to forgive yourself and move on, give your mind and body a break from all the shame and guilt you've been carrying by replacing them with gratitude. If you have a significant other in your life, thank him or her for caring for you every day. Thank the salesperson in a store who waits on you for helping you. Be grateful for what you receive. In some cases, it's not what you have done that you can't forgive. Sometimes you try to take the blame for things that have been done to you. Perhaps you were abused as a child and you blame yourself for that happening. If only sets in and becomes the rationalization for your guilt. If only I had not gone there. If only I had fought back. If only I had kicked and screamed. If only I had told someone. If only I hadn't believed him or her when they said, no one will believe you. If only. You just can't seem to forgive yourself for being a child, for being vulnerable, for being a victim. Reassure yourself that you did the best you could under the circumstances and you survived. Forgive yourself and you will not get struck with lightning. Shame is a familiar part of your life, and it is scary to give up what you know, or what if forgiveness feels worse. We need to remember that forgiveness is how we heal, and healing cannot be worse. Shame is what keeps you stuck under a really heavy weight that is not yours to carry. There is no shame in being a victim. You didn't choose what happened to you. Forgive like you have done nothing wrong, because you haven't. You are innocent. You may forgive yourself and still believe you were at fault, just as you might forgive someone else even though you think the person was in the wrong. You can have regret for what you did, yet accept that you're human and made mistakes. Perhaps you did your best, given your circumstances, your awareness, maturity, and experience at the time. If you continue to have difficulties with self-forgiveness, it's helpful to see a counsellor. A professional who is not immediately involved with the situation is often the best help in clearly seeing how our feelings and actions towards ourselves can have detrimental effects on our health and the people around us. But most of all, don't forget, forgiveness is a verb and you have to keep committing to it. Shame and guilt are familiar and may keep coming back to us for a while. Expect them, greet them, and let them go until they are gone forever. Love yourself. Accept yourself. Forgive yourself. And be good to yourself. Because without you, the rest of us are without a source of many wonderful things. Thank you, Rosemary. That appeared back in the February 2014 edition of The Healer and was written sometime prior to that. Now, I was umming and ahhing again this morning as to which piece of music to play at the end today, and Tracy was pulling her hair out because I couldn't decide. So I have made a decision, and I'm just going to cue it up now. I hope you enjoy this piece of music as much as I do. It may not be exactly the right piece of music to play after that lovely reading, but I'm sure you'll enjoy it. So I'm going to end today with Boyzone. Sit back, close your eyes, take one nice big deep breath and enjoy the beautiful voices of Stephen Gatley and Ronan Keating.
No matter what they tell us, no matter what they do, no matter what they teach us, what we believe is true. No matter what they call us, however they attack,
Such a lovely song. And thank you all for being with us again today. And just remember, as our motto states, wherever you are, we are here for you. So the sanctuary is just a phone call or an email away at any time. Have a lovely Sunday. Bye for now. And don't forget, if you're free at 11 o'clock UK time, join Jean for the Sunday service here on Facebook. So I'll just leave you with Love's Promise from Stuart Jones as we tidy up tonight. Take care, everybody. Bye-bye. Bye-bye, everybody. Have a nice day. Take care.